Hi friends, welcome back. This is Santosh Kumar. Today we are going to start BODE plot. So till now we completed 4 units. Last time we completed the root locus. We have seen get problems there. Okay. So till now in all 4 units we follow the same thing. The 50% weightage to the problems and 40% or 50% weightage to the theory part. Isn't it? We'll follow the same in the upcoming unit and this unit also. So don't worry about that. Okay. So first I'll give you the brief summary of what we have done yet. Okay, so it's like in the last unit, see, the stability analysis, we started from the Routh-Hurwitz table, correct? So it's kind of stability analysis we are doing. Okay, perfectly fine. We have seen first RH criteria, isn't it? In the RH criteria, as I told you earlier, here we, you know, we take the characteristic equation equal to 0 always. This is our consideration. This is the reference point. So in the RH criteria, we always take the characteristic equation. So directly over here, we are directly studying the stability. Okay. But now the remaining root locus, we have completed this BODE plot. And polar and Nye case, we are going to do the same thing, the system analysis, stability analysis only. But to find out the system stability by these 3 methods, it is indirect method. This is indirect kind of thing. Why indirect kind of thing? Because definitely we are going to consider the stability of the closed loop system only. Because stability is only defined for the closed loop control system. If your system is not closed loop control system, how you will find out the stability? Okay. So, or I can say, this is the controlled stability. That's why we are considering the closed loop control system. Okay. I'm not going into the open loop transfer function kind of thing. So, over here, we'll consider the open loop transfer function. Open loop transfer function means G of S, H of S, we are considering over here. Okay, this is our reference point. So we are doing whatever given inside in these procedures in the root locus we have done. We have taken the OLTA, but initially, or you know, the we considered the open loop transfer function, no problem at all. But whatever we have done yet, we did for the closed loop system. Okay, we discussed in the root locus. You can watch the video there, so it will be clear to you. So all this in BODE plot also, in the polar and Nyquist plot also, we are going to consider the open loop transfer function only. These all methods are the indirect stability finding out approaches or methods. Okay. So in the BODE plot also, we'll consider the open loop transfer function. Okay. So always G of S, H of S will be the center of attraction for us now. Okay friends, so let's start the BODE plot today. So what is the purpose? To draw the frequency response of the open loop transfer function? Definitely we'll draw the frequency response only. The next one is to find the closed loop stability. Okay, we are dealing with the closed loop systems only. To find the gain and phase margin, here two new things introduced, that is the gain margin and phase margin, we'll see it. Okay, the next point is to find the relative stability. Here also the relative stability, everywhere relative stability concept will be there, but the best method to find out the relative stability is the root locus, and the best method to find out the absolute stability is the RH criteria. Remember this point always. Okay, to find the relative stability, we are going to use the BODE plot also. And here one condition, if your GM and PM, gain margin and phase margin, these are the largest, then this give the more relative stability, but the system become very slow, okay, sluggish. Small value of GMPM max, the system lays relatively stable and the system response become more oscillatory. If your GMPM is very high, the system will be relatively stable, no problem at all, but system will be very slow, okay. And if GMPM value is very small, again your system is oscillatory. So we need the optimum value. So for the control system, closed loop control system, what are the optimum values for GM and PM? Let's see it. Optimum value of the GM is 5 to 10 dB. Okay, later we are going to discuss about this dB. Okay. So optimum value of the gain margin is 5 to 10 dB and the phase margin is, the phase margin is 30 to 40 degree. This is in degree. Okay. So this was the purpose of BODE plot. Now let's start it. BODE plot consists by two plots. Okay, friends. One is magnitude plot and second is phase plot. Whenever we'll be having transfer function, that is open loop transfer function, we'll find out two plots, magnitude plots and phase plot. We'll draw magnitude and phase. So the point is, okay, we have to understand what is this decade. Friends, in root locus, let me take pen over here. Okay, in the root locus, the scale was linear scale. The scale over which we have drawn the root locus, it was linear scale over here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This was the linear scale. That's why the output, whatever graph we plotted on the S plane, was symmetrical about the real axis. But here in the BODE plot, we are using non-linear scale BODE plot. In the BODE plot, we are using semi-log scale. In the semi-log scale, the frequency part will be vary according to the log function. Okay. And magnitude will be as it is. So this is the semi-log. In the semi-log and the decade, what is the mean of decade? See, wait a minute. Decade means, suppose at this point your frequency is omega, over here is omega 2. So the relation between omega 2 and omega 1 is like this, 10 times of omega 1. This next frequency, just next point, will be 10 times of the previous one. This will be 100 times of omega 1, original one. This will be 1000 times of omega 1. This is the log scale and this is decade. Okay. If the same thing will be in octave, it means the next frequency, let's take it like this, the next frequency will be 2 times of previous one, means last frequency. And over here, the next frequency is 10 times of last frequency. Okay, so we have relation between decade and octave also, and the relation is 20 log 10 is equal to this, in this is given in decade, is equal to 20 log 2 in octave. So you need not to remember this one, you have to remember 20 dB per decade is equal to 6 dB per octave. This is the relation actually. If in the decade your system is going to move like 20 dB per decade, in the octave scale or in this, it will be 6 dB per octave. Okay, what is the octave and what is the decade? You know now. Okay, 10 times of the previous one. This is the method in decade, and in the octave 2 times increment. Okay, so these two scales are non-linear scales. So if this is the non-linear scale, in the BODE plot we'll not get the symmetrical plot. The plot over here will get is asymmetrical. Is it okay to you? Now let's come to the procedure, how to draw the BODE plot. Very important. In the question, you will have open loop transfer function. Let's take, and this is G of H, S, H of S. That is, let's take, I'm taking K is plus 1 kind of. Okay. So the first point, very first point, replace the S by J omega. This is omega to convert into frequency domain. As we are, you know, the first point of the purpose, we have to draw the frequency response. So first, we'll take this S. This S is also in the S domain or frequency domain, but this is the Laplace point we considered. So what we will do, we'll come into the Shuddh frequency form. So we'll put the S equal to J omega. Definitely, we know about this point, S equal to J omega. So the first point is replace the S by J omega. Over here, it will become G J omega H J omega. Here K and J omega plus 1. Okay, the first point is over. Let's come to the second point. Find out the magnitude and convert into dB. Okay, the magnitude of this, the magnitude of this K, magnitude of J omega plus 1. I think you know very well how to find out the magnitude. This is omega square plus 1 under root. The second point is over. You know about this, how to find this. If you have A plus JB and someone is asking for the magnitude will be A square plus B square whole root. Okay. Let's come to the third one. Find out the magnitude in dB. Okay. They're asking the convert into dB. How to convert into dB? You have to take the 20 log of the particular one. Means, now we are going to convert this into dB. The magnitude will be in dB now. How you will do this? You will take 20 log of this magnitude. Is it okay? Just follow the steps. Okay. So this is the third point clear. The third point is magnitude in dB you have to find out. Okay. Magnitude is okay. Now the next point is find the phase angle. The phase angle of this. This is the original one. Now let's find the phase of this. Phase of J omega, H of J omega. Okay. Now phase, this is K, J omega plus 1. So the numerator phase is 0. In denominator, the phase is 10 inverse omega by 1. You know very well, the phase of this A plus IB is 10 inverse B by A. Is it clear, friends? Okay. So, now these two are in division. So, it will be 0 minus 10 inverse omega. Okay. So, finally, your magnitude for this question is 10 inverse omega minus 10 inverse omega. So, magnitude is over. Now, the next point is draw the BODE plot. Now, you have two things. Earlier, we have seen in the BODE plot, we draw two things. One is magnitude plot. Second is phase plot. Now, you have magnitude over here. You have this magnitude and you have this phase. You have to take different values of omega and we'll draw the phase and magnitude plot. Okay. So, this is the, you know, pictorial view of the procedure. Now, we'll take the, we'll start the taking question. So, it will be better understand to you people. Okay. So, the question is, or heading is, draw the BODE plot for the GH is equal to K. Constant is given. Very, very important. Please watch it carefully. Okay. So, the first point is we have to convert into frequency domain. Over here, no frequency term in this side. So, definitely, if you will convert, it will be like this only. J omega equal to K. The first point is over. Okay. Now, next is you have to find out the magnitude and phase. So, let's find out the magnitude. Magnitude of this is nothing but magnitude of K, that is K. Second point is over. Okay. Let's find out the angle. So, angle is nothing but GH J omega. Directly, I am writing over here. Is there any angle provided by this? No, angle is zero. The constant quantity always provides the zero angle. Okay. Now we have to convert the magnitude in dB or not. So here is the magnitude. How you will convert into dB? Your magnitude is going to be in dB, and it will be, you have to take 20 log. Always you will take 20 log of whatever is given, that is K given. Okay, so this is your magnitude, that is 20 log K. This is your magnitude. Okay, so over here we have to find out the slope also. We need slope value for the BODE plot. Okay, so slope is what? Slope, see friends, if I'm taking, I'm just showing the slope to you people, okay, I'm not drawing anything related to BODE plot. If this is the point and I have to find out the slope of this, slope means the angle with horizontal. Okay, so how to find out this slope is nothing but the tan theta, given by the tan theta. The tan of this angle is nothing but the slope. So here this is the height on the y-axis, that is dy, and over here it's dx. So tan theta is nothing but dy by dx, isn't it? So this theta is nothing, this tan theta is entire thing is nothing but the slope. So over here also I'll find out this slope. Let's take it as nothing but dy by dx. Here I'll draw the BODE plot. What I had to do, I had to plot two graphs. One is magnitude and second one is phase plot, isn't it? The first point we have seen related to the BODE plot. So magnitude, magnitude is what? Magnitude in dB I have to plot always. Magnitude I'll take in dB, phase I'll take in degree. Okay, so 20 log K is there. So this is the 20 log K you have to draw, but over here the slope is 0. You see, on the y-axis you are taking slope d by, and here this is not omega, this is log omega. Okay, because this is the semi log scale, over here your frequency is varying by log omega. Over here definitely you are taking magnitude. So the y is 20 log K, isn't it? I'm just finding out the slope. You know very well, for the constant the slope is 0, but how it is I'm showing to you people. Over here it's a log omega, this is the constant term, so definitely the slope is 0. Means you have to draw the line simply whose slope is 0. Your line is not going to this like this like this, it's going to parallel with x-axis. Okay, and the magnitude of this line is nothing but 20 log K. Okay, is it okay to you? So now the magnitude is, it depends on K value or not. If your K is greater than 1, then only you will get the magnitude above to this line. Otherwise you will get over here your magnitude, isn't it? Because your magnitude is purely depend on, over here purely depends on K value. If K is negative, your the same thing, same line will come over here or not, tell me, if your K is less than 1. Okay, so this will be actual magnitude plot for this. And this is the K equal to 1 line. Why this is K equal to 1 line? In the dB scale it's a 0 or not. So the magnitude in dB, if you will put over here 1, K equal to 1, so it will be 0 or not, mdB 20 log 1. So log 1 is 0. So over here in dB scale it's a 0. So 0 at K equal to 1. So this line indicates K equal to 1. This line indicates the magnitude for K greater than 1, and this line the magnitude for K less than 1. Is it clear to you? Is there any doubt to you people? Yes or no? Please mention this. Okay. Now you have to draw the phase plot, and the phase plot is simply 0. So if this is your phase line, so this is the entire line of phase having 0 degree for any value of K from 0 to infinity, whatever you will take the value, you always get the 0. Why? Because it's constant value. So for constant quantity, can I conclude myself? GHS, if you have K, then your slope will be 0 dB per decade. Okay, this is the log scale I'm taking, the variation in the frequency by decade. Okay, so slope is 0 dB. What is magnitude? Magnitude is 20 log K. Okay, this is in dB. And what is phase? Phase is 0 degree. Okay, friends. So, for over here in many books the procedure is different, but whatever we will follow is whenever we'll get or we have to draw the Bode plot, we'll always shift that particular by 20 log K. Later I'll discuss to this point, okay, don't worry. So for the first class, the introduction of the Bode plots, it's enough. I think in the next class we'll see some more points related to this. Soon we will finish the Bode plot, don't worry. And soon we'll finish the control system. Okay, friends. So we will meet in the next class. Till then, take care and bye.